Today, my family and I arrived to Egypt, fleeing conflict and persecution. We are seeking safety and international protection here. Protection means being received in a place where we'll be safe and not forced to return against our will to a place where our life or fundamental rights will be at risk. We might be able to have access to basic human rights such as education, health, and fair legal representation. If you are seeking asylum in Egypt, you have to register with UNHCR first. UNHCR registers refugees and asylum seekers and conducts refugee status determination on behalf of the government of Egypt. Having the registration documents help us regularize our stay in Egypt. The registration documents also facilitates access to education, health, legal assistance, and other services provided by the UNHCR and its partners. The registration document allowed my family and I to issue the residence permit. Through the registration card, we were able to obtain the residency permit, which is crucial to enroll my children in school. It also facilitates the process of applying for a driver's license. I am benefiting from the primary health care at the Ministry of Health and Population Facilities and Care for Chronic Diseases or Mental Health with support of UNHCR partners. Procedures will be clearly explained throughout your journey with UNHCR, from registration to status determination. This journey could be long, therefore, your attention to procedures is required. The first step is to go visit UNHCR premises on 17 Makkal Mukarrama Street, 6th of October City. There you will be handed a registration appointment slip by a UNHCR staff member. Based on your individual profile and complexity of your case, you might be requested to sit for one interview, only which includes registration and RSD, or two separate interviews. You should prepare the following original documents, if available, prior to your appointment. Passports and all available identification cards, such as driver's license or other civil documents, marriage certificates, death certificates to any member of the family, if applicable, education certificates, high school diplomas, and or university degrees, proof of previous registration with UNHCR in other countries, if any, military service certificates, two passport size photographs of each member of the family with a white background, and most importantly, your appointment slip. On your interview date, all family members must be present, and don't forget to bring all your documents. I remember the day of the interview very well. It was a long day that lasted hours. Our advice to you is to be patient and prepare yourself and your family for a long wait. Upon arrival, we were issued a waiting number, taken until it was our turn. All documents were checked by the UNHCR staff member. We were given another token. We waited until one of the UNHCR staff called our number. Once our number was called, we were guided by a UNHCR staff member to register and take photos of the whole family. The whole family also underwent iris scan, except for our baby, because he is under 4 years old. During the interview, we were asked about our personal information, such as name, country of origin, background, nationality, occupation and education, reasons for leaving the country of origin, relatives, registration at any other UNHCR office, and other questions. Our interview ran smoothly. We had all the requested documents ready during the interview and followed all procedures. We received the UNHCR yellow card for asylum seekers. The interviewer explained to us the procedures for obtaining a residency permit card. We also received an information booklet that illustrates how to access services available in Egypt and contact information of UNHCR partners. Some asylum seekers did not have their original identity papers, such a certificate of asylum application known as the white paper was issued. It does not enable its holder to obtain a residency permit, but serves as proof of an asylum application in Egypt that is pending consideration for refugee status determination with the UNHCR office. Based on this white card, the holder will be granted international protection considerations. It is valid for 6 months, so make sure to renew it before its expiry date. On the date specified on the voucher, I contacted the UNHCR office as a primary applicant for the interview.
Depending on the individual profile and the complexity of the case, other members of your family might undergo individual RSD interviews. During the interview, I explained the reasons that forced me to leave my country and led me to seek asylum. I told the truth without falsification or alteration of facts.
Providing false information will be detected by UNHCR staff and can harm your application. Therefore, please make sure to provide correct information at all times. We received a result slip, which indicated that we should start checking the RSD result website 6 months after the interview. rsd.unhcregypt.org. The result appeared. I went to UNHCR 6th of October office with the registration cards and official identity documents. We were notified of our recognition by a UNHCR staff member and were issued a blue card. We were recognized as refugees. So we received the UNHCR blue card, meaning that we enjoy refugee status and are under the protection of the Egyptian government. All refugees get notified when their results are out by SMS. They visit the main building and are informed of the result, whether they are approved or rejected. In case of a rejection, they receive a letter explaining how they can appeal and on which grounds. Asylum seekers who are not recognized as refugees have the right to appeal only within a period of 30 days. Appeals filed after this period will not be considered. Free legal aid providing NGOs can assist you in submitting your appeal application. The applicant can visit UNHCR 6th of October office to file an appeal, and a staff member will explain the procedure. Accepting an appeal means you have obtained the refugee status. If your appeal is rejected, you will be notified in a written document and your case will be closed.